Hello everyone. Today I am presenting on fingerspelling, the sign language tool. As you all know that many of the research for the blind people has been already done, like text TTY you get on every phone, even the lift buttons that have braille. But what about the hearing and speech impaired? They communicate in sign languages. So for sign language, now we don't know sign language. So for that, we have created this tool, sign language app, that will help you learn sign language, and that will test you. You can learn, practice, and test. So, what the sign language does? In this application, we have whenever you press a key on the keyboard, suppose A, it will show you the corresponding sign language gesture that is of A. And whenever there's a practice app or a test app, that whenever you have to check whether you are doing A correctly, so you get the camera feed. So you choose your webcam of your laptop. You do the gesture in front of the laptop, and it shows you the gesture of A. Our tool has three modules: learn, practice, and test. In learn, you learn how the gesture app works. Whenever you, like suppose you press a key on the keyboard, it gives you the gesture and animation of A. It has been made on Blender and Blender game engine. Not just that, we have hosted the application online. So suppose few people don't want keyboard read. So they can use the mouse, and you click on the button that are below. There are buttons from A to Z. You click on A, it will show you the 3D model of A. So we went on the first to a school in Gorega. They teach sign language, and we went to visit them, and we had a good time. So they basically loved our app, and they took all the files, and they took the application. And they requested that the web application to be hosted so that they can use it anytime they want. So I'll show you the game. So first is basically the instructions of the tool. So when you press A, it will give you the animation of A. B, similarly you can do it for S, till A to Z basically. So we use the open free hosting Heroku to host the app. So this gives you a 3D model that you can view even in VR. You can rotate, you can control the animation speeds. Another amazing part of this tool that we have developed is the image processing part. A research has been conducted by Microsoft that converts sign language, but it doesn't teach you sign language. Moreover, it requires Kinect, Xbox Kinect, that costs like 10,000. And other tools that are made for the sign language require like gloves and Arduino kit. Even that becomes costly, because practically we have reduced the cost to zero. So this is the demonstration of the Python code, OpenCV. This mod, learn and testing, the OpenCV is under testing and it is still under development. Right now we have been able to build up to E. So this gives you a model of A. So like when you go, so you can see that there's A. Now sometimes due to the background noise, it might be, and low lighting, it gets affected. Now you can see that the projector gets detected sometimes, because even that's doing E, and it's appearing over here. Something that's similar. It doesn't, because C and D have the same thing. Like C is like this, and D is like this. So the detection of, I'll show you detection of D. So it's due to the noise, low lighting. So wherever D is detected, it will make a box. Like you could see, there's a blue box. Yes. So wherever D is detected, so like here, so there will be a blue box, and there will be D written inside the box. Similarly for all the characters. So it is because of low lighting. So there was basically noise, and due to that it was affecting. I'll show you the actual videos that we took that day when we went to Sanskar Dham, the school where sign language is taught. So this is a gesture detection. So they tried the detection app also. So you can see that B is getting detected, B, C, and like sir said, that gesture of D and C. Yes. No, it's okay. So if you do gestures with left hand or right hand. Yes. No, it doesn't get detected. That's it, sir. Thank you. Well, whenever you want to communicate in sign language, the grammar of sign language is very different. Like when I want to ask you, like, where are you? So I won't do the gesture of full where are you. I'll just ask where are you. Just that much. So ata Marathi jari karaycha mhatla tari it will be like kuthe ayes tu. So it won't make a difference because the sign language works on the meaning of the sentence.
Then why are you teaching them ABCD?
Because right from the beginning when you are starting, you learn ABCD.
Why?
Sir, because you write exams.
No, I'm very sorry. You do not start learning ABCD from the beginning. Okay? Never.
A child, English-born child, American-born child, does not learn ABCD. He says, where are you? Mama, papa. Bread, omelette. That's all he learns.
But what about proper nouns?
I want. So, no, you said you start ABCD. What I am saying is, why are you starting teaching them ABCD?
We learn ABCD for proper nouns. Like when I have to say my name is Tejas. So there's no gesture defined for Tejas. I have to spell out Tejas.
That is different.
So for that you require the answer.
No. No. Actually, no. I can say Teja. That is good enough. Why that S is important? See, anyway, he is not going to speak Tejas or Teja. But what difference does it make? I can be any, anything. Okay.
But, so
I'll explain
you the same thing in a different scenario. You want to go from Andheri to Borivali. Now what will you do?
What I will do? Okay, I have got a car. Okay, I put the key and go. Okay, if I don't know, I'll do Google Map, and that lady will keep saying, turn right, turn left, and that's it, done, finished.
But if you're
and I can listen.
Thank you, sir.